Today, we are facing a new space era, which will lead to sustainable lunar habitats, 10-minute space vacation, orbiting space hotels, and the first human on Mars. However, space is an extreme hostile environment for human health, with temperature extremes, lack of atmospheric pressure, cosmic radiation, and microgravity. Since the first space missions, it was clear that transitioning from Earth's gravity to another is much more difficult than it appears. Human physiology undergoes severe changes as a result of exposure to less gravity, known as microgravity. These alterations include changes in the cardiovascular, muscular, and neural systems. When you enter microgravity, the gravity pressure on your body is suddenly relieved, prompting fluid to migrate from your legs to your upper body and head. And indeed, you might have noticed that astronauts have a puffy-looking face when they are in space. Structural brain changes have been observed in astronauts after returning from the International Space Station, or ISS. These include the brain physically moving upwards inside the skull and a reduced connectivity between the areas on the outer layer of our brain, our cortex, and those deeply inside. It's really difficult for the human brain to deal with microgravity. Studies have shown that changes in the central nervous system occur during and after space flight. Microgravity causes the vestibular functions of the body, which is the balance and coordination controlled in our inner ear, to not easily align with information received by the other senses, such as vision and proprioception. The brain cannot therefore currently interpret all these incoming sensory signal, and as a consequence, between 40 and 60% of astronauts develop the so-called space adaptation syndrome during the first days or weeks of spaceflight. Symptoms include dizziness, vertigo, headaches, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, as well as disorientation. And for this reason, no activities outside the spacecraft or spacewalks are allowed during the first few days of space missions. It would be way too risky. My research focuses on understanding how gravity shapes behavior here on Earth and how gravities not related to planet Earth can impact cognition and performance during space flight. We have recently demonstrated that alteration in gravity make people suboptimal in taking decisions, as well as less risk averse and poor in understanding others' action and intentions. The absence of gravity can be very unsettling and can compromise human performance in many different ways. With an eye towards human space missions to the Moon and Mars, it is a pressing research goal to get a better understanding of how gravity shapes behavior and cognition.